What's up, guys? First Hand Account here with another video, and today I'm going to be talking about digital zines or just photography zines in general. So first of all, I just want to say I was super inspired by Willem Verbeek. He has a YouTube channel and an Instagram account that I follow, both of them. His work is extremely amazing, and he does a lot of medium format film work. He shoots a lot on Fuji Pro 400 and Portra 400, and shoots a lot of stuff around New York City and New Jersey area. So please check out his work below. It's amazing. So if you follow me on Instagram, you might have noticed that over the past like 4 or 5 months, I've been really interested in digital photography zines. So what I do is I use an app called Unfold, and Unfold is a super popular app that people use to kind of spice up their stories or make their stories stand out from other people's just by changing the layout and themes. I'm sure you guys have seen this overused a ton on Instagram. So I wanted to create kind of my version of, you know, how I would use the app and use the app in a different way than everyone else was using them. So I decided to make digital zines, basically short series of photographs that I take at, you know, a county fair or an art fair or just walking around with my girlfriend, because me and my girlfriend love to go on walks. And I just collect a lot of those images and I put them together in short collections that I put online. So a brief background about zines in general. They became really popular in the 80s and the 90s when inkjet printers were becoming really popular in the consumer space, and a lot of people that couldn't afford computers were buying computers, and a lot of people that couldn't afford digital or inkjet printers were now buying printers. So a lot of people were printing their own photos on inkjet printers at home and printing their own documents and stuff like that. So a lot of artists saw this as a new accessible way to create short series or to create artwork and, you know, distribute it to a large number of people for not that much investment. So they made short little, you know, 8-page books out of 1 page of 8.5 by 11 printer paper, and they would just cut it and fold it in a way that created an 8-page little booklet. And some people would illustrate on them and then scan it and then print it and do comics and magazines and short stories and, you know, photography little booklets. I've seen hundreds of different kinds of zines. I went to the Minneapolis College of Art and Design, and there we have a course called Media One, and it's just a general media course. But one of the things that you do is you have to make a zine of some sort. So artists from all different mediums would, you know, make in a little 8-page booklet, and it was super, super cool to see that experience there. So I wanted to take this a step further and do it in a digital way. I think that, you know, the accessibility of iPhone or smartphone photography and smartphones in general, and, you know, the fact that we have a computer in our pockets now, and over 55% of the entire population in the world has smartphones now. So it's extremely accessible to create artwork and to use these apps that are, you know, artist studios, full digital studios in your pocket. And I think it's an amazing time. A lot of people complain about the oversaturation of artwork or photography in general, and I think it's a really, really amazing thing, because we're seeing all of these different ways that the technology can be used, and people are exploring all of the technology in a way that they never have before because of the accessibility. So I wanted to take Instagram stories and kind of put my spin on it. So I do these zines like weekly or bi-weekly, and if I, you know, have time to go out to an event or to go walk around with my girlfriend, I'll just make a short little zine. I put together the zines in an app called Unfold, like I said before. These are basically just explorations of different things that I've wanted to do. These aren't photos that I'm gonna post on my Instagram necessarily, but there's a lot of work that I produce that I still really value and I still put a lot of time into, and I'm still exploring a lot of different concepts even if I'm not using Instagram as the main distribution method for it. So this is kind of where I explore different series that I'm working on, or I'm creating a photo book currently about chairs. I know that sounds super abstract and different, but I have reasoning and intention behind why chairs mean so much to me and why I think it will mean something to people when they look at the photos. But I'm super excited to take you guys on the you know, along the ride and show you guys that process. But yeah, I kind of get a lot of questions online about why I produce these little digital zines, and I just wanted to give a little bit of background on zines themselves and tell you guys why I like creating them so much. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, my Instagram is Firsthand Account. I'll leave the link below. And I also have a street photography account called Firsthand Moments, where I post only street photography. So if you want to check out my work, follow both of those pages down below. I post the zines on my main account, Firsthand Account. So like I said, they come out weekly or bi-weekly, but I just want to thank everybody who's been watching these videos and everybody who supports me on Instagram. I really, really, truly appreciate it. And you know, I couldn't do a lot of what I do today without you guys. So thank you. If you're new, please hit subscribe down below and follow my Instagram pages if you want to see more photos from me or more videos like this. So other than that, I hope you guys have a good one. Peace.